Drown ourselves in all that goes on. You say fear the reaper, I say bring him on. You probably follow. I'm on the new wave. You're looking hollow. I found a new way. Show me how you do. Tell me how you feel. Cause you say you're living fine all the time, but I know what's real. And it's all the same. Tell me how you deal. Cause you've been waiting on the next thing I would say. I'm on a new wave. I'm on a new wave.
Hello, hello, welcome to the show. Today, we're talking about it's basically be quiet, hush. I got an email, and I love these email episodes. They make life so easy. So it's basically like I'm getting to the point, and I'm getting in and out. So, but today, this email was a very important email, okay? Listen up. All right, here we go. Dear Daryl, I am needing some assistance. I'm here for your assistance. I'm in a serious relationship with my girlfriend. We have no real issues. The only issue is that she loves to kiss and tell. Oh, that's never a good thing. Anyway, she tells all of her girlfriends about some of the sexual acts we do in the bedroom. And I even believe one of her friends is intrigued by some of the stuff that she tells them. There's nothing wrong with that, man. You've been doing pretty good. That's what she's trying to say. But it is something bad if she's trying to get with you. Let me finish the email first, all right? One of her friends is intrigued by the stuff that she's telling her. I'm not here to gloat or brag. I just would like to know, is it cool to kiss and tell? No, it is never cool to kiss and tell. For the simple fact, the things you're going through now, you're saying her friend is intrigued. Because she probably be like, oh, man. Yo, y'all don't understand. He has a big, he know what he doing, and oh my God, that boy, he can use his tongue in places. That gonna spark the attention for all of them friends. So, not just one. She probably just the one that's showing you. All of them probably thinking, when you walk in the room, they're probably like looking at you, like, damn, I wonder how big it really is. Or I wonder if he really can give it to me the way she says. She's getting it every night. You know what I'm saying? They thinking that. So she putting you in a bad situation. And I really feel for you, man. I really feel for you, man. It's nothing you're gonna be able to do, really. Because now, unfortunately, they've been friends probably longer than you've been together. So she probably known these people since school. And it's no way around it. So for the rest of your life, they're gonna be thinking like, I really want to probably try that. But if you're lucky she's my homegirl, I would try you, bro. And you gotta deal with that. And that's why it's hard on good men. It's hard out here on us good men. Because of stuff like that. So, unfortunately, I got nothing to say. But, yo, you stuck with that for a long time, you know. But you could tell her, just like, hey, man. Can you not talk about our sexual stuff to anyone? Let's keep it to ourselves. And, I don't mind doing all this crazy stuff. But I don't want you to be telling everybody. And if she really loved you and respect you, she really not even gonna get mad about nothing like that. She probably like, all right, man, I understand. And you'll be pretty good. But to the person that's telling everybody all of the stuff y'all be doing, so to your wife or girlfriend, you should be like, I'm talking directly to you. So the girlfriend should say, whenever you're out with your girls and they come down and y'all talking about sexual stuff, you already know it's embarrassing. For him to walk into a room knowing that you telling him about him licking your toes or something like that, and he don't want everybody to know he be sucking toes. Cause toes are nasty, you know. People don't really, toes are nasty, man. Just keep all that stuff to yourselves. Y'all can go in the room, get buck wild in there, lock the door. But when y'all unlock that door, all that stuff that happened in the bedroom, leave it in the bedroom.
These these dirty secrets are for me and you. Me and you.
Sometimes the best thing we all can do is just be quiet. But I do understand that we all want to share all of our good experiences with our friends and family. So get freaky, get nasty, but keep that under the cover and out of your friends and family's ears. But when it comes to sexual behaviors in the bedroom, it really should stay between you and her. I do a talk show because in certain situations, I talk a lot. And if me and you are cool, I'm pretty sure that I probably will spill the beans on something that was supposed to be confidential. But when it comes to my sexual talents and attributes, I would rather keep them private. So baby, if you want to get wild and freaky on top of the lawnmower in the garage again, I'm cool with that. But let's keep that between us. Until next time. Good night.